What's going on, Imperials? It's Emperor Cubone here. Looking back at Pokémon on the Switch thus far, we've seen some pretty great things as far as side games, but it's fair to say that the main series has been controversial. Generation 8 changed many things that we've come to expect, not the least of which was DLC that got mixed reception at best. Then of course there were the Sinnoh remakes, and I've enjoyed those greatly, but of course they rubbed some people the wrong way. Maybe we'll be rescued from this controversy with Legends Arceus, but even the start of Pokémon on the Switch wasn't clear, with many people being upset that the first thing we got was yet another Kanto remake. But if we're being honest, I think that the Let's Go games have aged maybe the best of any Pokémon property on the Switch. And we can't deny that it was indeed a jumping on point for many people that had only played Go to a more traditional Pokémon game. Not to mention that they are still solidly in the top 10 best-selling games on the Switch. So I think it's not out of the question to expect that the Let's Go branch of Pokémon games may continue. And I know that this was said back when we first saw Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee, but the evidence since then has made it seem even more likely, especially if other studios are going to be getting involved now. So, aside from the unique catching mechanics, the biggest defining characteristic of a Let's Go game is, of course, your partner Pokémon. They will be your very first Pokémon, and you'll be able to interact with them in a special way that you can't do with any of the others that you catch. But, of course, they will not be able to evolve, since it would be kind of hard to carry a Blastoise on top of your head, but they do get extra strength so that they can still be usable throughout the game. So, what kinds of Pokémon could effectively take on these mantles as mascots for their respective regions? Johto would be the next in line, and truthfully would be hotly anticipated, since the last Johto games are still held in high regard. Plus, it would be pretty cool to have two regions on a Switch game. So, which Johto Pokémon could become our precious partners? Well, we've actually got some options. I think personally that Pichu would be required as one of the mascots. The only downside that people might say is that it's related to Pikachu, but I think that makes it perfect. Plus, it would help to cement their propensity for sticking it to Raichu by giving the baby a game cover first. You would probably have to buff it a lot because its evolution last time needed it, and Pichu is significantly weaker. But it could get a sweet signature move. Literally, it would probably be incredibly adorable. As for the other version that Johto would provide, a popular choice by many fans was Meryl, and that does make sense from a marketing perspective, as it was frequently shown before Gen 2, and it is another mouse Pokémon that started as a base stage and then got a baby later. So maybe Mr. Peekablue could get away with it, but I do think that there is one better fit in this scenario with Togepi. This fairy egg was the first major new Pokémon introduction ever, really, by being advertised in the anime constantly for years before its in-game debut. So, getting to play with your Togepi and giving it a bunch of extra powers seems to fit perfectly with this enigmatic spike ball. So, would they sell as well with Let's Go Pichu and Let's Go Togepi? Yeah, I kinda think so, actually. And if I'm honest, I could see the Johto versions of Let's Go as the end of that kind of game series. But it would also be kind of stupid to give up on it if they can settle for pumping one of these out of generation. So for the sake of argument, which Pokémon from Hoenn would be marketable enough to pull off their own game? Let's Go Sharpedo, perhaps? Probably not. I would say that Let's Go Plusle and Minun could be a possibility, but then the mascots would have the same typing, which wouldn't really make it much of a choice. Personally, I think the underrated Skitty could be a perfect partner. I could definitely see it being playful and eating berries, not to mention riding on top of the player's head. This friendly feline deserves so much more love and could definitely be one of these partner Pokémon. Besides that, I would lean towards Ralts, but that might actually get kind of weird to basically use a small child to win battles, so instead, I'll just say why not. We'll probably have to adjust its moveset quite a bit, even if it is just some new powerful signature psychic attacks. I do think that Why Not could be off the wall enough to draw in many fans to choose it as a partner for a trip through the Hoenn region. Once again, I do like the Sinnoh games that we have for the Switch now, but I can also see why some people wouldn't, so I think that doing them in a Let's Go style, closer to what people might have expected, would be most welcome from fans across the board. As for what they could use for these Let's Go versions, I do think the obvious first choice is Riolu. If there is one Pokémon to represent Sinnoh in general, it is undoubtedly Lucario. So, making its younger form your partner makes perfect sense. And honestly, a boosted fighting type would do pretty well across most of this region. So I would imagine that Let's Go Riolu would be a very popular game. As for the other version partner, I would like to say Shinx because I do love that line of Pokémon, but if I'm honest, I think the most likely option is Buniri. This cute little rabbit is every bit as personable as the last option, so I could see them in many great interactions with plenty of outlandish expressions sprinkled in, and the ability to dress it up as well. Also, I just remembered that they added a gender difference to Eevee when it became your starter, so there would probably be a new way to tell whether your Buniri was a boy or a girl, so that would be cool too. Let's Go Unova might be the one other option that people would be interested in, but hopefully we wouldn't get that before an actual Unova remake or sequel or whatever. But if there's one Pokémon that could be a mascot here, it has got to be Zorua. Much like last time, Zoroark has a big part in its region, so its smaller pre-evolution as a partner I think would be a prime pick for putting it on the cover. Not to mention the cool illusion-based signature moves that could be designed. And it would be interesting to finally start with a Dark-type Pokémon from the very beginning. And hey, maybe we could even see something about its new regional form with our rival having one or something like that. Its counterpart, I would say, could be Mincino because it fits in just about every way possible, except that wouldn't be great marketing to write that complicated name on the box. So instead, I will say this could be pulled off by our good buddy, Axew. This tiny dragon was clearly represented in the anime as perfect material for a partner Pokémon. Maybe even a little goofier than you might expect, especially compared to Zorua, but speaking of that, it would make a nice pair of titles with one being A and the other being Z, so I think that it could work, and finally give Axew something since it's not even actually a pseudo-legendary Pokémon. Although maybe the dragon type might be a little overpowered at the start of the game. Kalos actually has quite a few options that I could totally see working, like Litleo or Skiddo, but those would be kinda hard to ride on your shoulder. The same with Flabébé that would be good, but would be far too small to interact with effectively. Another great one would be Helioptile that could work, but once again, that name is a bit too involved for decent branding. So if you ask me, the Kalos version of this should start with Let's Go Inkay. It might sound weird to make a hypnotic squid your mascot, but it's not like he's a total creep yet in this stage, and as a special Let's Go partner, he never will be. Plus, having multiple options for inverting stat changes would be a good strategy to try, or at the very least, its constant flipping around in battle and in play would be quite endearing. A good counterpart, I think, would be Let's Go Pancham. Firstly, this little guy is a fighting type, which would create an interesting dynamic between the psychic and dark type Inkay. But I also think that our Kung Fu Panda would be the perfect mix of cute, but tough enough to stay that form through the entire game and believably succeed. Not to mention the wonderful facial expressions it would provide. But I do think that this is about the closest we could get to a human-like Pokémon and it not be weird to have them riding on your head. In my mind, the Alola region seems for some reason to be the least likely to get a Let's Go style game. Maybe something more like a Ranger game with temporary captures, but we'll still play along. So my first recommendation would be a Let's Go Rockruff. We got tons of clout surrounding this Pokémon's evolutions and their various forms, but sometimes it seems like the base stage gets lost in the shuffle. So I think giving this charming stone pup his day in the sun, or moon, am I right guys? Would be most deserving. Everyone should know how great this Pokémon is. For the other version, I think just about the only other Pokémon that could work is Mimikyu. Sure, you could go with a Jangmo-o or like an Oricorio, but is there really any other Pokémon that's been as popular from Gen 7 as this disguised Poltergeist? Ghost and Fairy is a great type pairing to have through the whole game, and with its ability, it might not even need to get buffed. I'm assuming that they'll still have abilities. I mean, they did in Gen 7. I just assumed that in the first ones they didn't because Kanto started without abilities, but hey, maybe that's just a Let's Go feature. But the point is that if you slap a Mimikyu on the cover of a Pokémon game, people will buy it up, for sure. I guess I found another way to overshadow poor Rockruff again, huh? Our current final region is Galar, and if ever they do get a Let's Go-style game, it'll be quite a few years before we'd see it. But there are still some strong candidates, like a Let's Go Yamper. I thought of maybe using Toxel, but that would probably throw too many temper tantrums as it is still more of a baby, so I think that Yamper is the ideal adorable electric creature from this region. This would essentially mean that you get to be Sonya for a game, and have this lightning corgi follow you around everywhere just like her. In fact, that would be a pretty cool gimmick if it was set a little bit in the past and you got to see Leon as a kid and everything. Anyway, Yamper is at just the right amount of appreciation to get away with this honor. In fact, I think the only other Pokémon that might be able to surpass it from Galar is Wooloo. This thing took the fanbase by storm, and when this rotund sheep ball was first introduced, people were captivated by its cuteness. Not only is it delightful, but even its mannerisms are endearing, such as its sleeping or even the propensity for rolling around everywhere. I could see a special move leaning into that by calling in a whole stampede of Wooloo wrecking balls, like Yoshi's Final Smash. I think a Let's Go Wooloo game would simply sell itself for people clamoring to get such a special experience with this precious lamb of a Pokémon. So, those are all the Pokémon that I think could actually pull off being mascots for their own Let's Go games. What kind of Let's Go game would you most like to see? Let me know down in the comments. Also, be sure to leave a like, share this video, and subscribe so that you too can become an Imperial today. We'll see you around next time!